last night, like I mentioned earlier, I went to the Baptist church in Daytona, and they had a huge choir, and there was probably over 400 people in the choir, and they had an orchestra, big orchestra, and it was so much fun. It was just, we sang praises and listened to them, testimonies, and it was just really, really special. So, who can tell, what is an orchestra? Who can tell me what an orchestra is? Mari? Right, it's a place where all the instruments come together to play, and they play together. Now, in an orchestra, and I've never played in an orchestra, but like all the violins are together, all the violas are together, the cellos, the trumpets are together, the oboes, all the instruments are in their own group, and they're called a section. There's a string section, a horn section. And there's a very important part for each section. There's a leader for each section in the orchestra. Of course, there's the conductor. But in each section, there's a leader. And the first leader, the most important one, is referred to as first chair. Then there's second chair. And sometimes there's third chair. So now you know what an orchestra is, and you know what first chair is. The first chair person is the other people, the other musicians in that group look to that first chair person for cues and different things. It's a very important job. And that person who's in first chair is a very good, plays that instrument very well, and is a good leader. So, about 22 years ago, I decided I wanted to be a camp nurse. And so I wanted to be a camp nurse at, I should stay like that. I wanted to be a camp nurse at Interlochen Arts and Music Camp in Northern Michigan. This is a huge camp. Kids come from all around the world to this camp, and it's from grades 3 to 12, and they go there to hone their skill, to become better at their instrument or their art, whatever it is they choose. And and there's, what did I say, over 2,000 students there they see every year, and it's in the woods. Anyway, so I went there, and I stayed in the dorm, and every day I would go to my job, and my job was at the Junior Intermediate Girls Infirmary, which we call JIG for short. And that was a nice little rustic clinic in the woods. And every day the girls would come in, and if they needed to take medicine, they would take their medicine. Or if they were sick, they would come in, we would try to find out what was wrong with them. Do they need to call a doctor? Do they have medicine for that, or what? And sometimes we would find out that they're not really sick, they're homesick. As you can imagine, they're like thousands of miles from home, and some of them were there for 2 months. So one day, a girl probably about 12 years old came in, and she was, "Oh, I just don't feel good." And so I was asking her all kinds of questions, trying to find out why she doesn't feel good. Was she really sick? Did I need to call the doctor? Was she homesick? Well, here's what she told me finally. She said, my parents are coming this weekend, and I don't want them to come. I said, why? Well, I was first chair in the orchestra, and they bumped me down to third chair. And she felt so bad that she was bumped down to third chair. She wasn't good enough to be in first chair anymore. And she felt so bad that she didn't want her parents to come and hear her play. Now, I don't know whatever happened after that. I don't remember that I ever saw her again. But I thought about that over the years, and I thought, how sad that she would feel so bad because she wasn't good enough to be in first chair, that she wouldn't even want her parents to come and hear her. And, you know, how often are we like that? We try to be so good. We try to be good, do all the right things so that we can be in first chair and go to heaven. But in the Bible, it tells us in Isaiah 64, verse 6, that all of our righteousness, all of our rightness, all of the things that we do right and good, it's not good enough. It's not going to get us to heaven. So what do? Do we give up and say, well, I'm just going to be bad then? No. We give up all of everything to Jesus. And we ask Jesus into our hearts every day. We pray to Jesus. And we ask Jesus to help us get through the day. We ask him to help us make the right decisions. We ask him to please help us get through these problems that we're having right now. And he wants to. So bad he wants to help each one of us. You, with all of your things that you have going on in your lives, he loves you. He died on the cross. It's his goodness, and it's his mercy, and it's his righteousness that's going to take us to heaven. And the closer we get to Jesus, the more we know that. And before we even realize that we're doing things we don't even think about because of our relationship with God, because of how much he loves us and how much we love him. And we want to share with others what he's done for us, how he's helped us. And so it's not our goodness, it's God's goodness that helps us get to heaven.
Amen.
Okay? Now, there's a song. Do you know the song, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus? Okay. Do you want to sing it with me? And y'all, anybody who knows this song, sing it with me. Because I want you to pay really close attention to the words. Love you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.